So we've talked about using Riemann sums to estimate area under the curve. But if you notice, we've always chosen functions where the function was positive above the x-axis. And so our rectangles were coming up from the x-axis and going to the function. But what does it do to our Riemann sum if part of the function goes below the x-axis? Well, let's kind of see if we can figure this out. Here we have a rectangle that's sitting below the x-axis. For this rectangle, the width is still delta x, and the height is this length right here. But when we plug into f of x right here, we get a negative number. Well, we know that lengths can't be negative, right? But we don't have any way in our Riemann sum formula here to account for the fact that this is negative. So what ends up happening is for this portion of the graph that's under the curve, we get negative the area that's there. So what's going to happen is that this area up here is going to be positive, and the area that's below the x-axis is going to be a negative number. So if this is area B and this is area C, then when we calculate our Riemann sum, we're actually going to be calculating the number, the area B minus the area C. We call this the net area because it's how much area you have left after you subtract any negative area. You should compare this to the idea of displacement. Similarly, displacement gives you how much distance you have left after you subtract any distance going backwards in the negative direction.